I've used ACDSee for many years, and I think it's the best file manager I've tried. Recently, I bought another camera and wanted to be able to edit RAW files, so I looked at the latest version of ACDSee, since it was able to edit RAW files from most cameras. I've used a variety of image editors, but now I use ACDSee almost exclusively. In this video, I'll cover some of the features of management mode that I use, which will start to show the power and versatility of ACDSee. Let's start with importing files. You can import from several sources, disk drives, CDs, devices like phones, or even a scanner. I'll import from a USB thumb drive. I've chosen the settings that import to a folder with today's date. When the import is complete, you are prompted to view the files in their folder. It's nice to categorize your images as you import them, but you can do it at any time and change or add categories as desired. Just turn on the Properties pane by right-clicking an image and clicking Properties. Or you can use the pane's drop-down menu and click Properties. Then expand to Categories. I haven't categorized these images, so I'll put the first two in the History and Nostalgia categories. The third I will put in the Structure category, but notice the plus sign. It indicates subcategories. I will expand the Structures category and also add this image to Barn. I will also select all images in this folder and add them to the ACDSee Tutorial category. As an addition to categories, or as an alternate to categories, you can assign keywords in the same way as you assign categories. As you can see, I have created many keywords in my database. Like categories, keywords can have sub-keywords too. For example, I'll create the sub-keyword Cessna under the keyword Ariel. In addition to your own categories and keywords, you can use predefined ratings and color labels. I'll assign the rating of 3 to the first two images and a color of red to the next two images. Even the thumbnails show the number and color. Only one color and one number can be assigned to each image. Once you have categorized your images, you can use the Catalog pane to retrieve them. Turn on the Catalog pane by clicking on the Panes menu and selecting Catalog. You can then retrieve all images for a category simply by clicking on the category. I'll select Rating 3 to see the images just marked, or the color red to see the images labeled red. If I click on Nostalgia, I get all the images I have placed in that category. While browsing is typically done from the Folders pane, there are other ways to group images to restrict browsing to a smaller group. For example, let's create a collection for the current images. I need to turn on the Collections pane using the Panes drop-down menu. I'll select all the images in this folder, since I want to add them to my new collection. I right-click in the Collections pane and select Create Collections. I'll give it the name ACDSee Management Tutorial. I want this as a separate collection, so I turn off the check for Inside a Collection Set. I want the currently selected photos as part of the set, so I click that box. I don't need it to be a target set, so I turn off that checkbox. I click Create to complete creation of the collection. We can then return to the collection when we want to work on the images. Deleting a collection does not delete the images which were assigned to the collection. If we look at the properties for the first image, we can see the EXIF data show the GPS coordinates where the image was taken, as recorded by the camera. I can use the map pane to show the location on a map of the images containing the map coordinates. In this case, the first image was shot by a DJI Phantom 3 Advanced, and the coordinates were assigned automatically. Selecting the image and opening the map pane will show the location on the map where the image was shot. Rather than use the panes menu, I just right-click on the image and select map, and then view on map. I can zoom in on the map to see more detail, and I can click on the satellite box to show a satellite view. The balloon shows the position of the drone when the photo was taken. While some of my cameras can record the location, using the GPS runs the batteries down faster, so I rarely use it. The next image does not have coordinates, as we can see from the EXIF GPS properties. However, we can open the map and search for the location. In this case, Saratana Mill, Missoula. We can drag the image to the map, or we can right-click on the image and select Place on Map, and then click Save All to save the coordinates. Note, now the GPS fields in the EXIF data are populated. Sometimes you may want to collect images in a special folder and make a shortcut to the folder. You can use the Shortcuts pane to do this. I'll open the Shortcuts pane from the Panes menu. Then I right-click on the Shortcuts folder and select New and Shortcut. I can browse to the location. In this case, I select the folder I use for some frames to rename for this video and click Next. I'll name the shortcut Rename Images and click Finish. This creates the shortcut to the images. Clicking on the shortcut shows the images. I'll click the back arrow to return to my previous files. You can add your own data to the data associated with an image as part of the ACDSee metadata or the IPTC data. With the properties pane open and the ACDSee metadata expanded, you can see that I have set ACDSee caption for the first sample image. I'll expand the IPTC data and set the IPTC subject code for this image to history. Be sure to press the Enter key to save the entry. You can use batch changes to make changes to multiple files. For example, I could use batch changes to rename files used for this video. I'll use the shortcut just created to display the images to rename. I select all the images in this folder by selecting the first image, then holding down the Shift key, and click on the last image to select all the images. Then I right-click on any of the images and select Batch, Rename. You could then click the Use Template box to use a template to make a totally new prefix and use the pound symbol to add numbers. You can see in the preview window what the new names will be. Or turn off the Use Template box and select Search and Replace tab. Click on the Use Search and Replace box, then use the Search For and Replace With boxes to modify existing names. Again, seeing the changes in the preview window before committing the action with the Start Rename box. You can also do some batch processing with built-in actions. Actions are sets of editing instructions, and these are sets of instructions that come with ACDSee. We'll cover both development and editing later, but here might be a good intro to future activities. I'll right-click on the first image and select Browse Actions and select HDR Natural. I'll click Play and the action will produce a new HDR image from the single image. Returning to Manage mode, we can compare the two images side by side by selecting one, pressing the Control key, and clicking on the next image you want to compare. Finally, right-click on one of the selected images and select Compare Images. You can clearly see that the lighting has been spread more evenly after the HDR action. You can use the Dashboard tab to look at summaries of your photography activities. You can see yearly photo count, monthly photo counts, a database summary, a summary of camera activity, and a summary of file types. Hovering the mouse over the various summaries provides additional detail. We have just looked at some of the ways I use ACDSee to make managing files easy. There are multiple ways of doing the things I have shown, so the user will develop their own styles for file management. Like any powerful software tool, you won't use all the tools provided, but there are plenty of tools from which to select to customize your use of the software. Thank you for viewing. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to my channel.